Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Ninja Gaiden. We're now in Act 4 where most of the story is going to be explained.
Welcome to your Hayabusa, sorry if I startled you. We are from the CIA Special Auxiliary Unit. My name is Foster.
Dot dot dot.
Getting right to the point.
Wait. I want to know why you killed Smith.
We didn't kill him, but we'll fill you in on what we know.
In sexy pre-Windows PowerPoint fashion! Yes! I love this. This just looks so hilarious.
In the upper reaches of the Amazon, some ancient ruins were discovered. It seems the temple was built more than 2,000 years ago. The discoverer was Dr. Smith, who studied the ruins for some time. But one day, he suddenly sealed off the ruins. And ever since then, no one has gone close. Are you impressed with the fact my mouth is not moving and I'm saying all this? Later, however, a man moved in and took over the ruins. His name is Guardian Demir. He calls himself Junkio.
The main enemy of the game?
According to our records, it seems that the temple is not where gods are worshipped, but the spell to imprison the body of the demon. Therefore, evil spirits are supposed to be held in the statue you have. Dr. Smith probably already knew that. He was probably killed by someone working for Takiya. Why would Takiya want one of the ugliest statues in the history of anything?
Dot.
When a black moon shines, light and dark break apart, the king of darkness howls. These were the last words written on the stone tablet. If someone brings the demon back to life, he will gain incredible power and incredible ugliness, enough to control the entire world.
And now the entire game has boiled down to a world domination plot.
So, you know about that?
The woman who shot you in the bar was one of our agents. They are after you. Use this and go to their headquarters, get the demon statue back from them. Of course, you will be paid for the work.
And if I say no?
And in cliche fashion,
you know the answer to that.
It's not a very menacing voice, is it? So yeah, instead of mindlessly running around like we were doing for the last three parts, now we actually have a place to go and a reason for going there. Now granted, I don't think the plot of this game is anything to really look into too much. It's not exactly a great plot, even though it uses cutscenes. But now, you have more bearing, and things make sense. What doesn't make sense is how floaty red spiders or fire ants are candles, or hold stuff. Either way, welcome to the Amazon, part 4. This is when things are really going to ramp up in difficulty, because nature is still after you, as you see, and more damn birds, of course, because, well, what's a Ninja Gaiden game without birds, really? It's not a Ninja Gaiden game. I'll tell you that. So, yes, there are also bats that show up in broad daylight here. Unless the forests are so huge that they blot out the sun, in which case that would actually be kind of crazy. I've heard of flocks of passenger pigeons, which are now extinct, that actually used to blot out the sun because there were so many of them, and due to overhunting, among other things, they were actually rendered extinct. I'm not sure exactly when, I think it was the 19th century, but still. Also, why are birds after Ryu? And I understand some of the people on Jakio's payroll, but kamikaze football players? And how are the birds and cougars involved? And the bats? I think Dracula wants his bats back, by the way. Speaking of which, there's a cutscene of the castle. You see one of these, and every Ninja Gaiden game on the NES. So if you've played this before, and want to play the next two, get used to that type of scene where Ryu's admiring something. And suddenly we end up in a mine shaft where we actually get to face ninjas that try to do helmet splitting techniques and then run around like idiots before trying another helmet splitting technique. This isn't too bad, and of course you gotta face the jack-o'-lantern guys because those guys make total sense in the world. I'll mention more about the music later, but this is my favorite piece of music in the game, without question. It's very upbeat for what you're doing. And right there, I did not want to get that small shuriken, because here is another example of having a certain weapon for a certain situation, and the windmill shuriken is actually the one you want. Because you see all the birds that come out from out of nowhere? Well, yeah, that's exactly what happens if you get the wrong sub-weapon at times. Disaster strikes. And you die. And the game gives you that death jingle, which sounds a lot like kicking a man when he's down. And one of the very few times where Ryu will actually lose his health from and die from that, rather than dying from a This Is Sparta death. Crazy world, huh? But anyway, this time, I'm not going to make that mistake. I'm keeping the windmill shuriken all the way through, and you're going to watch it absolutely rip ass. And I didn't get the clock there, unfortunately, but that's not a big deal, because this is the power of the windmill shuriken. Ripping birds, ripping ninjas, ripping more birds, ripping more ninjas. Because that boomerang effect is so helpful. Like I said, it's one of the best weapons out there, really. Even though it's kind of difficult to control. It's one of those high-risk, high-reward ones. Like, you wouldn't want to use it as a basic shuriken. And that's 4-2 for you. Not a 4-3, which has the mystery music, which is very, very slow and monotonous and repetitive as all hell. Why does this exist in this area? I guess it makes sense, but why is Mike Tyson fighting for the Jacquillo here? I have no clue, but it is stupid, and these guys are being jerks and throwing stuff at me. What's that glove doing guy doing there? I don't know. Why is he throwing maces at me? This is such a silly thing to do. What is Jacquillo thinking, having these guys on the payroll? After all, it makes no sense. Why has Ryu gone from getting vengeance to now uncovering a major domination plot? And I hate those tornado kick guys. They are very unpredictable and will cause me tons of pain throughout this game, because it is annoying to fight them. It is really annoying, so because that's unpredictable, and they will not hesitate to chain their jumps and make it very hard for you to hit them, and damn soldier guy just smarted me to death. Because I left the windmill shuriken once more, and now I know that it's not to happen again, because I am smart and I am thinking that's why I died to a stupid soldier. What a stupid move that was on my part. This is making me lose my breath very quickly, because for some reason this really, really hurts my mouth. Throat. My mouth too, by the way. But anyway, Jason Voorhees reject again. Seriously, this is really a monotonous piece of music. I like it, but come on. This is just silly. Really. Also, I was wondering why that guy actually got held up by the wall. Ryu's supposed to be the magnet to the wall, not those tornado kick guys. Either way, done with 4-3, so now time to fight the stage 4 boss. This guy is actually really, really easy. The two demon dogs. Jaquillo's personal pets. Only one can be hit. The other one, I think, can be destroyed, but takes no damage to the enemy health bar. The one that jumps farther is the one that gets hit. And normally if you just camp underneath one of the pedestals, you're safe. No matter what. You might have to move around a little bit here and there, but other than that, you should be generally safe. This is a very easy boss if you position yourself right. And don't get too aggressive, just let them come after you. Because after all, they have a very set pattern. In the second game, you fight these guys again, and they're much, much tougher unless you have a certain sub-weapon.
You have come a long way to bringing me the demon statue. Now give it to me.
Oh, I love this next part. Devoted for one word. No!
Do you know what you're saying?
What?
Ryu!
You coward.
Don't tell an evil guy that he's a coward.
No, don't give it to him.
Now, put down this demon statue on the floor and back up.
Don't do it to a random stranger.
Nice work. I guess this is goodbye. Have a nice day.
Ryu, you're a ninja. Aware of your surroundings.
Ah, take the girl away. She is going to be a sacrifice.
Ha ha ha.
It's mine. Tonight is the night of rebirth, which comes only once every 700 years. This world will soon be mine. Ha ha ha.
Ugly face! Ha 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 ha. Cue the cliche thunderbolts. Well, anyway, this is the end of that. Next time, Act 5. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.